Hello, scientific writers. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a scientific poster using PowerPoint. Hi, this is Brian from the Grants and Publications YouTube channel. Let's get started on this poster. As you see on the screen, I have opened PowerPoint. The first thing I do is I save my file. So I do a save as. Now that I've saved the file, I'm ready to get started. The first thing I need to do is to make sure that I'm going to make the poster at the correct size. Well, I have checked with the conference I'm going to. I've looked at their instructions very carefully, and I know the maximum poster size that I can make it. And so I'm going to set it for that by going to Design, go all the way over here to Slide Size, choose page setup. We're going to use 34 inches by 46 inches. And then just go ahead and say scale. All right, now you see that the slide orientation has changed. Then I'm going to go back to the home ribbon and change the layout so that it's blank. The next step is to format the background. So I'm going to do a right click on the slide and go down to format background. And I click that, and then I can choose the background I want to use. And these are the settings I would like. The next step is to add my title text box. So go up here to text box, click that, and now it's asking you to draw a text box. So I'll just make one about this size. And now I'm going to change the font to the font I want, which is Arial, because it's a nice readable sans serif font. And for font size for a title, we're going to go with 80. I'm going to enter the title of my poster. I've already prepared all of my text and all of my figures, and I have them saved in a single folder so that they are easy to access, so that I can easily copy and paste or insert all of the files or text that I need into this poster. And now I click on the border of this text box so that it's deselected the text, but it's selected the entire box. And I can center it, and I can fill the shape with the color I like that's going to make a little bit of contrast from the dark blue. And then I'm going to make the text bold. I'm going to move it up and center it along this guide. Make sure you have the guides turned on. The way you turn the guides on, if they're not on already, is go to View and then find the checkbox for guides and make sure it's checked. And at the same time, go ahead and turn on the ruler. So now that we've entered the text box for the title, let's duplicate that and then move the duplicate down below it. And what we'll do is replace this text with the text for our authors. Now I want the fonts to be a little bit smaller. So they're the same font because I just copied that text box. Select the whole box and we'll change it to 60 points. And then I'm going to select the university affiliation and make that one click smaller. My next step is to import all of my logos. So I like to do that by insert picture. So go up to the insert ribbon, click that, and then find picture, click the little down arrow, picture from file, and that's going to bring up my browser. I'll go to the desktop, find my poster materials folder, select my logos, and insert all of them at once. Okay, so they're all here. They're stacked on top of each other. Just click off of that and then click the first one and start moving it. The second one, start moving it, and just move all of them where you want them. And then we can resize by grabbing this corner. So make sure you grab the corner to resize it, because that keeps everything proportional. If you resize it by grabbing one of the sides, you see what happens. It changes the shape, and we want to keep the shape consistent. And we might resize these again later, so I'm not going to worry too much about size at this point. So now what I need to do is decide how I'm going to lay out this poster. Most of the time, I prefer to do a three-column layout. So I'm going to make three columns that are as equal in size as I can get them. Now, I'm not going to do this by eye. I need to do this using some guides. So I'm going to draw some temporary guides on this poster by going to Shapes and then clicking Line. And I'm going to draw a line that goes from top to bottom, and it's bigger than the poster, and I make sure it's a straight line. And now I'm going to change the weight of that line so I can see it more easily. I'll make it a 6-point line, and then I'm going to change the color to white. I'm going to duplicate that and move it over here. Now, are those columns even? I can tell they're not. So how do I make sure that the columns are even? So I'm going to zoom in on the poster, and when we zoom in, now we can see that the ruler has numbers on it. What we need to do is take 1/3 of 34. So that's approximately 11. 17 minus 11 is 6. So let's put this line on 6. Now we have 3 even columns. Now the next step is to start inserting text boxes for our headings. And I'm going to give it a fill with a different color fill this time. We'll use this light purple color. And I'm going to right click on this text box and say format shape. And so when I do that over on the right side, I get this format shape box. When I go to size and pull down text box, I'm going to say do not auto fit. What that will do is keep that text box the same size no matter what size font is in it. And that's a feature we want to use for the rest of these text boxes. So now I'm going to choose my font and font size. We're going to use 44, and I center that and I make it bold, and I'm going to pull this box a little bit tighter to the word. And if it makes it easier, you can always zoom in to do this. So now I'm going to duplicate this text box, and then I'll just move it around to the different places where I think it's going to be. And then I'm going to change the word to the other headings. I've got all my heading boxes ready. They might get moved around and resized a little bit. They're just in a place where I think they're going to be approximately at the end. So now I'm going to start inserting my text boxes for the text. We'll use font size 24 in these text boxes. Like I did before, I'm going to duplicate this several times. If I duplicate it too many times, it's no big deal. I just delete the extra ones. If I don't duplicate it enough, no big deal. I just do it one more time. And if the boxes are too big, it's easy to resize them. All right, so we have the boxes in place. Now I'm going to go to my text file where I have pre-written all of the text for the poster, and I'm going to copy and paste it into these boxes. All right, so I've added most of my text boxes. There are still some text boxes that will come in later. Those would be the figure legends and labels on other figures. So what I'll do now is start importing the figures. So you notice that I don't have much text in the methods. That's because I like to do a visual methods section. So I'm not going to have a lot of text there. I'm going to have a lot of figures and flowchart. So I'm going to import those figures and their labels right now. So now I have inserted all of my figures and all of my figure legend text boxes. I've chosen to be consistent with my color scheme. So all of my text boxes for the main text and for the figure legends are the same color. All of my heading boxes are the same color. And I think that makes it easier for your readers, and it puts less effort on their brain as they're interpreting your poster. So what I'm going to do now is resize some of these boxes, like this author box, and then I'll need to recenter it. So everything is on there. We just need to make it look more spaced out in an organized way. So I'm going to take these header rows and move those up. And also we want to make sure that they are aligned properly. So you see I've selected two boxes. Let me show you how I do that. I select one of them and then I hold down the shift key and select the second one. To make them in line, I'm going to go to arrange, align, top. You might have seen that the results box shifted up just a little bit. Now another thing you can do I'd like to show you is when you have a group of items that you want to move. So I want to move this entire group of items, but I want to move them together. I want them to stay in their relative place. So what I can do is select all of them one by clicking the first one, holding the shift key, and then clicking the rest of them. But you can see sometimes it's hard to do that because some of the items kind of overlap some of the other items. And now I'm going to go up here to arrange and group. So that turns all of those objects into a single group. Now I can move it as one unit. If you're not able to select them one by one, click and drag a box to select everything that you want to, and that will select all of them. And then you can do arrange group, and that makes those a group. I want a little bit of separation between these two groups because they're two different procedures within this methods section. And to accomplish that, I'm going to move my objectives heading and box up a little higher. So what I've done is selected those, and now I'm just using the arrow on my keyboard to move them up. But you can see that the distance between each of these items is not exactly the same. So what I'm going to do is select those four items and then go to arrange again, and then go down to align, and then go down to distribute vertically. And that's going to space them out evenly. So introduction and objectives go together. So I want those evenly spaced. And then I'll leave a little bit of gap here, a little bit of white space. Move this heading up a little bit so that I can move this grouping up a little bit and have some white space between this procedure and the procedure below it. That looks pretty good, but everything is not necessarily even within the column. So what I'm going to do is select everything in this column and then go to arrange, align, and align center. And what that does is it shifts everything so that they're all in line through the center. Now let's do the same thing in the second column. Okay, that spacing is about where I want it. I want the first three text boxes to be aligned with each other. All right, so I've aligned the third column through the center. I've got some white space between these different sections. I've got my logos for the funding agencies here. The last thing I want to do is align these logos with the title. Now I noticed on this first column, I need to move this grouping over a little bit because it was across that white guideline. Now I'm looking at everything from a distance. I think it looks the way I want it to. So what I can do is select these white guidelines and delete them. And this poster is done. I'm going to save it. Okay, so that's how you make a poster in PowerPoint. If you have any questions about that, leave them in the comments and I will try to answer. I have several videos on how to make posters and what are good features of posters. So take a look at those. If you got value from this video, please hit like and consider subscribing to the Grants and Publications YouTube channel if you'd like to see more videos on scientific writing related topics. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time and happy writing.